During the virtual 2020 COSI Science Festival, COSI's president and CEO, Dr. Frederic Bertley, had the opportunity to interview NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine. During that interview, Mr. Bridenstine had this to say about how upcoming missions to the Moon and Mars will inform future missions.
We're going to go and we're going to use the resources of the Moon, hundreds of millions of tons of water ice on the surface of the Moon. Water ice represents life support. It's air to breathe. It's water to drink. And in fact, it's rocket fuel. It's the same rocket fuel, hydrogen, liquid hydrogen, is the rocket fuel that powered the space shuttles. And it's available in hundreds of millions of tons on the surface of the Moon. But we're doing this with a purpose. The Moon is the proving ground. Mars is the destination. So we go to the Moon to learn how to live and work on another world so that we can go to Mars, which of course is an order of magnitude more difficult, but still accomplishable, and this agency intends to do that. We have now found liquid water 12 kilometers under the surface of Mars. What do we know about liquid water on Earth? Wherever it exists, there is life. Yep. Now, is that true on Mars? I don't know, but we should go find out. We now know that the methane cycles of Mars match the seasons of Mars. Does that guarantee life? No, but it could be. It's a strong indicator, so the probability just went up.
As you just heard, NASA has its sights set on Mars, and the NASA Mars Exploration Program has some very lofty scientific goals. They want to understand the climate and geology of Mars, to determine if Mars ever supported life, and ultimately to prepare for human exploration of Mars. They are conducting several missions to Mars to achieve these goals, including the Mars 2020 Perseverance Rover, which launched on July 30th, 2020. Perseverance is the most technologically sophisticated rover to ever be launched to our neighboring red planet. Perseverance will focus on searching for evidence of past microscopic life by exploring its landing site, Jezero Crater. Rock and dust will be collected by Perseverance's sample caching system, and future collaborative missions with the European Space Agency are being planned to return these samples to Earth for the first time via an orbiter. The samples will then be analyzed using equipment that's too large to transport all the way to Mars. In addition to studying the Martian surface, Perseverance's Mars Oxygen In Situ Resource Utilization Experiment, or MOXIE for short, will attempt to demonstrate the ability to convert Martian carbon dioxide into oxygen. If successful, this experiment will help to refine technology that could be used for future Mars missions to provide oxygen for rocket fuel and breathable air for passengers. And that's not all. Perseverance is also equipped with a robotic helicopter called Mars Ingenuity that will be used to further investigate portions of the Martian surface. This type of helicopter could potentially be used to explore other planets and moons in our solar system. Perseverance is on track to land on the surface of Mars in February of 2021, and we at COSI are so excited about the advancements it will make toward our understanding of the planet. What do you think Perseverance will find in the Jezero Crater? If you like this video, remember to like, subscribe, and comment below. And for more information on COSI, Columbus, Ohio's Center of Science and Industry, visit cosi.org.